Hi guys, it's Jessica.
And Mauro.
And welcome to our April What's New on FAQ. In this video, we're going to tell you about some new content updates for both PowerDirector 365 and the PowerDirector app.
That's right. Plus, we'll have our Q&A at the end of this video to answer questions you guys have for us.
Also, if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe and turn on the bell icon to get notified of new video updates.
For PowerDirector 365 this month, we got three new design packs to help you create awesome videos.
The new YouTube Video Templates Volume 1 and 2 includes 24 professionally designed templates that help creators produce engaging videos for their channel. Choose from various intro and outro templates to grab attention right from the start.
And shake things up with the Seamless Shake Transitions Pack with 16 great transitions to add between clips. Or transform videos with the Warm and Cozy LUTs Pack for the perfect look. These fantastic new packs will amplify creativity and add flair to any content. Plus, add fun and excitement to any video with our Cartoon Sound Effects Pack Volume 2.
The latest update for the PowerDirector app allows you to share edited videos straight to Instagram. And for our Android users, you can now upload directly to TikTok as well.
We've also added some new motion graphic titles and title effects that will make your text pop. Let's take a quick look.
And this next part is our favorite segment, the Q&A, where we answer your questions. Let's get right into it.
That's right. Our first question today is from MemesYT. I know this is probably really simple, but how do you put videos into Google Drive and then use that in PowerDirector? I'm on a phone. Well, unfortunately, this feature is not available in the iOS app. However, for all of you Android users out there, we're going to show you how. On the left-hand side menu, click on the media icon. Under the video and photo tabs, you'll find a Google Drive icon. Make sure to log into your Google account to give the app access to your videos and photos. Once you've logged in, you'll be able to see the video and photo files located in your drive. Then download the ones you need and add them to the timeline.
And the next question we've got is from Antonio Sanchez. How can I put music on my videos? So let's see how it's done in PC and app versions. In the PowerDirector app, open the Media tab in the top left and tap the Musical Note icon. As long as you've given the app permission, all your music will be accessible to add to your project. Just open an album and use the plus button to add a track to your project. If you have a subscription, you can also access the royalty-free music stock library. Select what genre of music you would like to add and preview the tracks. When you find the one you like, download it and add it to your project. In PowerDirector for PC, you can import your own audio files into the media library or use the background music and sound clips provided. Click on the Media Room tab on the left-hand side menu and you'll find the background music and sound clips listed. Filter the content categories and you can also preview the tracks first before downloading. Once the track is downloaded, drag it and drop it into the timeline. If you're subscribed to PowerDirector 365, you can also download music from the royalty-free stock library.
And next is a question from Timmy Boy. I don't see the pencil at the bottom left. Does anyone know what to do? Well, so I'm assuming this is the edit button for the PowerDirector app. So first, add the clip you'd like to edit on the timeline. Then tap on the clip again, and you'll see a pencil icon appear in the bottom left-hand corner here. This is where you can add effects and do adjustments for this clip.
And our last question is from Maria Paula Rodriguez Clavio. Can I adjust the video speed of a layer? So let's take a look how this is done in the app and PC. First, in the PowerDirector app, have the clip on the overlay track. Then tap on the clip and tap on the edit icon on the bottom left. Then scroll to the right and tap on speed. You can adjust the clip speed by using the slider on the right. In the PC version, have your clip on the timeline. Then click on the clip and click on the Tools tab. Find Video Speed and open the Video Speed Designer. Here, you can edit how long you want the duration of the clip to be and adjust the video speed by using the speed multiplier. And that's all for this video. Thanks for watching.
Let us know what you think about this month's update in the comments below. We'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.